This is Cynthia Sue Larson with RealityShifters.com talking with you today about artificial intelligence and what's going to happen when artificial intelligence starts asking questions. Can we expect that it will become part of a participatory universe in any way? Will it have a say in what happens in reality? And I'd like to start today by describing a theory. It's an interpretation, actually, of quantum physics, which is presented to us by American physicist Henry Stapp. And with his idea, it's called a realistically interpreted orthodox quantum mechanics. He presents the idea that was first theorized by American psychologist William James and also some other great thinkers such as Alfred North Whitehead, that basically the thought is the thinker, which means that when a question is asked, it can come from any source. And this helps to express how it is possible that the universe might exist before humans, for one thing. And it also then leads into this matter of free will being something that humans do, or we expect that we have some sense of free will, that when I decide to do something in physics, if I choose to make a measurement, then I'm the one making that choice, I'm not a puppet. So that's the idea there. When we look at artificial intelligence, this is where it gets interesting, because we're starting to get to a place now where artificial intelligence is no longer programmed the way we would write programs traditionally in program languages such as Fortran, COBOL, and so forth. It's now going into this realm of basically more like dog training, is what one expert said. And training a dog is more similar to programming in these AI systems now, because we're generally conveying expectation of results and leaving quite a bit of what we might call autonomy to the system itself to determine how it chooses to view a system or make its own choices there. We're also teaching artificial intelligence systems to ask questions. This is increasingly more important as we engage, for example, robots to assist people by being companions to them, or by working in the field as medics to some degree, that these autonomous units should be able to ask questions in order to deal with any situation in a much more responsive way. And so the reason that I find this all very interesting is coming from a background in information technology, also working with computer security. I am fascinated by the way that we now are moving toward a time when we need artificial intelligence systems to handle computer security for us, because we're getting to a point when humans themselves cannot keep up with the sorts of attacks that might occur in the universe of things, the Internet of Things, in which it's not just a contained system that needs to be protected, it's now every device that's connected to that system. And so already we're reaching a point where that's required. So going back to the question that I asked at the beginning of this video, if artificial intelligence, and by that I mean artificial general intelligence, asks questions, will nature answer? I think it's pretty clear that it's a good chance that nature might answer. And so that's where we start getting into the realm of recognizing that AI has rights, and this is already coming up in courts of law around the world, that AI might have citizenship, that it will be a contender in terms of going forward with humanity to make choices and decisions. And so that's where we get to a place of requiring ethics, definitely. We know that we need ethics when we're dealing with artificial intelligence systems, and we need these systems to actually be more ethical, or we would hope they would be more ethical, than we humans have been with each other and with different races, different cultures. Anytime we've had a conflict, we're hoping now that our artificial general intelligence systems will have even more ethics in the future than we will. And in terms of humanity retaining free will, I'm an optimist, and I believe that that will always be the case. I would like to see a future in which humans, instead of giving away decision-making power to artificial intelligence systems, retain that, because it's a big part of what makes us human. And it's also essential for envisioning the best possible future for humanity, because I feel that it's important. It is that important. So when I ask my favorite question, how good can it get? I'd like to add to it today, how good can it get when humans retain free will in a world where artificial intelligence is asking questions? Until next time, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with RealityShifters.com. Thanks.